that is the cultivation of anaerobes, right? So when we talk about anaerobes, already we have seen these things into the classification of bacteria, that it's all about the oxygen requirement, because in the classification of bacteria, we could see that there are microorganisms. Many of them, they required oxygen. Many of them, they required a little bit of oxygen, or many of them, they cannot live with oxygen. They'll be die with oxygen, right? So when we talk about only one gas, that is called oxygen. So in that oxygen also, there is a number of microorganisms, number of bacteria which can grow with oxygen and which cannot go with oxygen. So let us discuss how, when this, because this is not the simple task that simply you are preparing the one nutrient media and we are just inoculated that and we have kept it for the incubation and your cultivation will be done. No, here we need to take care about the bacteria or about the microorganism requirement, not only nutritional point of view, but also the surrounded, the what, how, what kind of habitat it is required, what kind of environment it is required to grow itself. Otherwise, they will not be able to survive, even though you have given very good laboratory, very good temperature, pH, and all those things you are taking care, right? That's what we could see into the classification, carbon dioxide, temperature, light, pH, oxygen, and all these things, they are matters. They definitely matters. Even though if it is a small life, they are having their own requirement. So let us understand what kind of the preparation we are supposed to do when we are trying to cultivate anaerobes bacteria, right? So when we talk about the anaerobes, it is nothing but here let us understand what kind of classification we can do in the basis of oxygen requirement, because the before going for the cultivation or culture of anaerobes, we need to understand what are the anaerobes bacteria and how they are different from the other bacteria, right? So when we talk about the first one, that is the obligate aerobes, right, sir? So obligate aerobes means it is require oxygen. They require oxygen to live, right? So that's the, for the survival, for the living of that particular bacteria, they have to consume the oxygen. Without oxygen, they are going to die. Examples are Pseudomonas and common nosocomial pathogen. Common nosocomial pathogen. These two are the example of obligate aerobes, right? Then the facultative anaerobes means here anaerobes, again AN has been attached to as a prefix, anaerobes. Anaerobes means again there should not be oxygen. So let us understand, it can use oxygen, right? But there is a condition, it can use oxygen, but can grow in its absence also, right? It can grow with oxygen and it cannot, right? So both the condition it is having, if oxygen is available, they can use. If it is not available, they can grow without the oxygen, right? That is the, that's what, that is the facultative anaerobes, right? So they have complex set of enzyme. That's what the examples are: E. coli, Staphylococcus, yeasts, and many intestinal bacteria, right? That's what E. coli, it can, the location of this bacteria, it is the intestine of healthy human, right? That's what it is having no specific requirements toward the oxygen. It can without the oxygen, it can be with the oxygen. That is the anaerobe. The obligate anaerobes, when we talk about obligate anaerobes, are, they cannot use oxygen. That's the condition. That's only we are, today's our task is going to, right? They cannot use oxygen. That you should know that they are not able to use the oxygen. That's what obligate anaerobes, right? So obligate anaerobes, they will not be able to use the particular oxygen and are harmed by the presence of the toxic form of oxygen, right? They are going to affected by the presence of the toxic form of oxygen because it is the particular gas oxygen. So examples of these obligate anaerobes are the Clostridium bacteria that cause tetanus and the bolutism, the botulism, right? So these two, these two disease it is causing, that is the Clostridium tetani. Okay, so this is the example which cannot use the oxygen, and with the oxygen they are going to die, right? So that is the thing. And coming to the, if you talk about the another type of obligate aerobes, you know that obligate aerobes, they require oxygen, right? So that is the only difference. Aerobes and anaerobes, you need to understand these two words carefully, right? When in exam also, you may get the question in a such a way, once if you'll see that you think that it is anaerobes and it may be aerobes, right? So the spelling you need to look at properly before attempting, because in both are come quite opposite. One is requiring oxygen and one cannot use oxygen, right? So in with this one small word that is the an, with that only it, the entire meaning is going to change. So you should be very careful when you are attempting this one. So today we are going to cultivate or culture the anaerobes, right? So apart from this, there are certain two category also, which is there based on the oxygen requirement, like a aerotolerant anaerobes, right? So here, as the name indicate, aero means air, tolerant means which can tolerate, anaerobes means without oxygen. So it cannot use oxygen, but conditions apply here. It cannot use oxygen, but tolerate its presence. It is not that much harmful, or with the presence of oxygen, they are going to die. It is not like that. They are not going to die if it is there also. Okay. But at the same time, they are not going to utilize that. They are not going to consume that oxygen for their energy production, and can break down toxic form of oxygen, right? And it can also break down, or it can digest that toxic form of oxygen if it is supplied or present. Examples of these particular bacteria, that is the lactobacillus, it carries out fermentation regardless of oxygen presence, right? So lactobacillus, that will be there into the milk, that we know that. So this is the aerotolerant anaerobes, right? So coming to the next category of the bacteria, that is the microaerophiles, right? Microaerophiles means it require oxygen, but again conditions applied. If it required oxygen, but at low concentration. If the concentration will increase, it will be problematic for them. They are not going to consume that. If it is in low concentration, they can utilize that. Sensitive to toxic form of oxygen, they are very much sensitive for the toxic form of oxygen, which if it is will be provided to them. So example, it is the Campylobacter, right? So this is the example that is comes under the microaerophiles. So how we are going to, what is the task basically here? We are going to culture the anaerobes, right? So which don't require oxygen. We are, because we know that oxygens are everywhere into the environment, into the atmosphere, right? So simply cultivating of the medicinal plant, or cultivation of the any other animals, or cultivation of the earthworm, cultivation of the normal microorganisms, this might be quite easy, because you will be having certain steps, procedures, techniques that what you are going to do, how we are going to do all those things. But here the condition is we are making the environment free from oxygen, when we know that everywhere there is oxygen. So that's one of the difficult tasks. So here the task is to reduce the oxygen content of culture medium and remove any oxygen already present inside the system or in the medium, because we are making the media culture media, agar media, agar nutrient agar media we are preparing, right? So how we can say that, because in nutrient agar media, this is the water, here we have kept agar powder, Peptone and all those things. We have meditated like how you are making your Horlicks in your milk. When you are adding Horlicks in the milk and you are you are shaking them, do you think there will be no oxygen? Until and unless you have not boiled it to 100 degree for more than 10 minutes, oxygen will be there, even inside the water also there are. So remove any oxygen already present inside the system. System in the sense, it may be glass apparatus, it may be box, it may be medium, or it may be your entire assembly where you are going to culture your microorganism that is called anaerobes bacteria. Right. So it's difficult. Actually, it is difficult task. Okay. So here, what is happening here? Oxygen is the ubiquitous in the air. Ubiquitous means everywhere. Everywhere it is there in the air or into the environment. Yes, that's what we are alive, because we need oxygen. Without oxygen, we are going to die. But we are going to cultivate the microorganism or bacteria, such type of microorganism which don't require oxygen. Right. So the task. So special methods are needed to culture anaerobic microorganism. Special methods are needed where the area we can make it free from oxygen, at the same time free from other microorganism. Okay, so that's difficult actually. So how we can do it? A number of procedures are available for the reducing the oxygen content of culture, right? Because we need to reduce that one. It should not be there. Some simple but suitable, mainly for the less sensitive organisms. Other are more complex but necessary for the growth of strict anaerobes. Right. So let us see that what kind of preparation can be done here. Like so many bottles or tubes we can use here. You can see the number of bottles and tubes it is available. Right. In that way, we can do that. So bottles or tubes fitted completely to the top with culture medium and provided with tightly fitting stopper. Why this tightly fitting and all this word it is coming? Because it should be airtight container. Airproof means air should not enter into your bottle or tube during incubation period, because in incubation period, if oxygen will able to enter where you have grown your microorganism, they are going to die because they are anaerobes. That's what that is the only theme of this cultivation. Okay, suitable for organisms not too sensitive to a small amount of oxygen. Okay, so that is the it is not to a small amount of oxygen means okay, addition of a reducing agent that reacts with the oxygen and reduce it to water. This kind of facility also it is available. Reducing agent, right? We can take the help of reducing agent which will react to the oxygen and reduce it in the water or in the media. So say for example, thioglycolate. Okay, thioglycolate, in thioglycolate growth, that is one of the media. Thioglycolate growth can be used. The media itself, it is having capability to reduce the oxygen, or it can react with the oxygen and it will reduce its amount or quantity or nearby the microorganism cultivation. After thioglycolate reacts with the oxygen, what happens? Throughout the tube, the oxygen can penetrate only near the top of the tube, where the medium contacts air. Okay, so basically what the thioglycolate it is doing here is, it is trying to reduce the quantity of oxygen molecule at certain area, right? That is going to clear in this next slide here. Here you can see the four tubes are there, These four tubes, what it is going to do is, with these four tubes, the obligate aerobes means which required oxygen, grow only at the top of such tubes. Here, oxygen concentration, you can see onto the top of these tubes, this area, this the brown color area or chocolate color area, oxygen concentration, it is high. Okay, so as soon as if you go down to the tube, oxygen concentration, it is going to reduce or it become low. Now in these kinds of packed culture vessel, when we are going for cultivation, the different types of microorganisms can grow depend on their oxygen requirement. So let us understand, obligate aerobes means which require oxygen. That's what we could see into the classification. Obligate aerobes grow only at the top of such tube, because top it is full of oxygen, high concentration of oxygen, and these microorganisms required oxygen, right? Obligate aerobes, right? Then coming to the next, the facultative organisms grow throughout the tube, but best near the top, right? Best near the top. Okay, so why it is required? Because they're having oxygen, they required, and they don't require also. So their partial requirement, they are not strict about oxygen. So in the throughout the tube, but based on near the top. So depend on the situation, they can grow. Coming to the microaerophiles means which grow near the top, but not right at the top. Near the top, but not right at the top, because again, they are having certain requirement. You can see here the facultative and oxygen here into the first. Facultative anaerobes means can use oxygen, but can grow in its absence, right? That's what throughout the tube they can what you call grow. That's what. And the microaerophiles means they require oxygen, but at low concentration. So it's all about the concentration, what they need. So according to that, they are going to anaerobes grow only near the bottom of the tube, where oxygen cannot penetrate here in the down anaerobes, right? Bottom of the tube. So here basically you can see that depend on to the an obligate anaerobes. Here you can see this is the microorganism. In obligate aerobes, required oxygen, and here high concentration of oxygen, that's what they're here. Obligate anaerobes, they don't require oxygen, that's what they're in the bottom. Facultative anaerobes, they are they can be everywhere, but this area they will be more, because they can use the oxygen. Then here the anaerobes means what do you call, they will be here, right? So depend on the oxygen requirement, they are going to grow into the tube where the oxygen concentration is more or less. Okay, that is the theme here. One thing we can do here, the redox indicator, because since it is packed culture vessel and where we are growing, so how we will come to know that what is going on over there? Because oxygen is not visible, microorganism is not visible up to certain extent, right? So the redox indicator dye called the rhizagurine, right? Rhizagurine, this is the structure of rhizagurine, one nitrogen molecule, it is attached into the middle ring and hydroxyl group and all this. Okay, it is added to the medium because the dye change color in the presence of oxygen. That is the indicator, that's what a redox indicator, whenever redox, right? So the dye or the color, the dye itself is color, dye change color in the presence of oxygen and thereby indicate the degree of penetration of oxygen into the medium. What is the quantity of oxygen has been penetrated to the medium? That you will come to know during the culture, during the cultivation when it is going on, or incubation it is going on. You will come to know that what is the amount of oxygen, because it is going to change the color, and by the change color changes you can see. That's what this rhizagurine, the redox indicator, can be used in such kind of culture. The strict anaerobes who don't require oxygen, with oxygen they are going to die, such as methazonic bacteria, methanogenic bacteria, it can be killed by even a brief exposure of oxygen, right? Because they are strict anaerobes. That's what they are known as, a strict anaerobes. In this case, a culture medium is first boiled because a small amount of oxygen also they don't require or they cannot tolerate. So we have to be very much careful when we are going to culture such kind of strict anaerobes like methanogenic bacteria. We need to boil the media. First, boil the media to render it oxygen free, right? To make it oxygen free, because once if you boil all the oxygen, it will get evaporate or air will evaporate and it will be free from any other gas also. First of all, we are bothered about oxygen only here, right? So it oxygen free, it become oxygen free, the culture medium will become oxygen free, and then a reducing agent such as hydrogen disulfide is added, H2S is added, and the mixture is sealed under the oxygen free gas. Oxygen free gas. So what will happen? Any other gas, if it will be there, if there will be no scope to enter something else, it will be packed, right, or sealed. So that method also, it is going to, this a step is also going to help us to make the surrounding free from oxygen. All the manipulations are carried out under the teeny jet oxygen free hydrogen, right? Teeny jet of oxygen free hydrogen. Okay. Under the teeny jet of oxygen free hydrogen or nitrogen gas. That is the directed into the culture vessel when it is opened at that time. Thus, the driving out any O2 that might enter. Okay. So that's what making the surrounding free, pack so that the scope will not be there, right, for other gas. For sensitive, for extensive research on anaerobes, the special boxes fitted with gloves. So these are the tools which we can use, right? For the certain research on the anaerobes, it has been done. Special boxes fitted with gloves called anaerobic gloves. Anaerobic glove boxes. In the next slide, I will tell you about the boxes, how the design will be there. And these boxes, it permit work with open cultures in completely anoxic atmosphere. What is anoxic atmosphere? Which is free from oxygen, but at the same time, it is atmosphere. Other gases may be there. Other gases may present, but there should not be oxygen, because here we are very much particular about oxygen. We don't want the oxygen should reach to our culture area, because our microorganism, it is anaerobes and they don't require, they're going to die with the oxygen. So that kind of anaerobic glove boxes are available. Then the astringent anaerobes can be grown only by taking special precaution to exclude all the atmospheric oxygen from the medium, because medium it required for every bacteria, and the medium it can be the carrier of oxygens to the microorganism if you have not taken care properly before culture, right? So that's what. Such an environment can be established by using one of the following method, right? That when we are talking about the particular types of environment where we are going to making the things free from oxygen. So the first one is the pre-reduced media. That's what, pre-reduced. Before we are going to reduce, or we are going to making them less in quantity, the media, right? So in that, what we are doing, during preparation, when we are preparing, the culture medium is boiled. That's what we could see in the previous slide also, right? The culture medium is boiled for several minutes. So why it is boiled for several minutes? So that it can be the oxygen can be removed from the particular media. Okay. for the several minutes to drive off most of the dissolved oxygen, right? When we are boiling the water molecules, all these things, the intramolecular force, the conduction of the heat and all those things, it happened, then all the gases, it will get evaporated, it will go to the bubbles of the oxygen, it will go to the surface, and there it will be brushed and it will mix with the atmosphere air, all those mechanisms you know very well, right? So this thing we are doing so that we can make it free from oxygen. A reducing agent are also available, some chemicals we can use. For example, cysteine is added to the further lower the oxygen content. So this chemical you should know, you should remember, cysteine can be used to reduce the oxygen present in the media, right? So this also, it is going to help you to making it free from oxygen. Oxygen-free nitrogen is the bubbled through the medium to kept in anaerobic. The medium is then dispensed into tube, which is being flushed with oxygen. Free nitrogen is stoppered tightly and sterilized by autoclave. Right. So what we are doing here, whatever the media which we think that it is required for our microorganism, anaerobic microorganism, that we are boiling. When we are boiling it, oxygens are removing, that media we are putting onto the, what do you call, particular vessels. That's what here it is, they are using stopper to make it tight. Because whatever the vessels we are going to use, whatever the container we are going to use, they should have the provision to make them tight, make them close in a such a way so that it can be called airtight container. It can be called airtight container, and then we are subjecting this particular media for the sterilization, that is by the autoclaving. Autoclave, all of you know, it is there here in the microbiology. I will show you all the equipments once you will come to the college, right? So here in autoclave, it is the basically a moisture heat sterilization we are doing. Whenever we cannot heat directly to the media, that's what here temperature and pressure, 121 degree centigrade temperature and 15 lb pressure we are applying, and with the temperature and pressure we are trying to remove all the microorganism expected into your media. That is only the theme when we are going for sterilization. Such tubes are then, whatever the tube we have kept for sterilization, such tubes are continuously flushed with oxygen, frees carbon dioxide by means of a cannula, rest opened and incubated, right? So during this also, these tubes, again, it will be the oxygen removal process, it will be go on, right? By means of cannula, and then we are subjecting the entire assembly for the incubation, right? So here, here you can see the box, how it is designed in a like a particular area. It has been covered properly because we are here anaerobic chamber. It is called a anaerobic chamber. So in this chamber, basically we are trying the oxygen should not reach, right? So this refers to a plastic anaerobic glove box. Right, that's what anaerobic glove box I have talked about you into the last slide. So this anaerobic glove box that contains an atmosphere of hydrogen, carbon dioxide and nitrogen, except oxygen, right? Other gases will be there. That's what it is called atmosphere. Why we are calling atmosphere? Because in atmosphere, there will be the group of gases, number of gases, more than one number, more than two number of gases supposed to be there, then only it will be called atmosphere. So we are making, or it is, this box is containing such a type of atmosphere where all other gases will be there, but not oxygen. Okay. Culture media are placed within the chamber by means of an airlock, right? By means of an airlock. which can be evacuated and refilled with nitrogen. Right, so you just understand here, it is placed within the chamber by means of airlock. Why it is required airlock? I told you many times, right? Because airlock, it will ensure that your oxygen, whatever it is there, apart from your artificial atmosphere to in this atmosphere, that should not enter, first of all, okay? Any oxygen in the media is slowly removed by reaction. Still, we can expect that oxygen may be there. In any oxygen, it may be there in media, even though if you have boiled, even though if you have sterilized, chances are there because, right? So, slowly removed by reaction with hydrogen, because this hydrogen or carbon dioxide and nitrogen, we have already filled into the box. So, this oxygen, suppose if any molecule, if it has by mistake, if it has gone also, what will happen? The reaction with the hydrogen and forming the water H2O, right? Because hydrogen, the H2 is already there, and oxygen, if it will be there in your media, they will form the water and reaction will take place. But that oxygen cannot be used by microorganism, or it will not reach to your microorganism to kill them and to disturb their growth. That is only the theme. This reaction is added by the palladium catalyzed. It's one of the catalyzed that if it will be there, it will initiate such kind of reaction to formation of water with the presence of oxygen. After being rendered oxygen free, the area, the media are inoculated, the media are inoculated within the chamber by means of glove port and incubated also within the chamber. So the inoculation and incubation, this both the work, it will be done within the chamber, inside the chamber. That's what we do in the laminar airflow. Why we are doing all the inoculation, all the transformation of the microorganism in the area of laminar airflow? Because we consider that is the aseptic area. That area is free from microorganism because UV lamp, it is there, and the sanitization has been done. In the same way, inside the box, this anaerobic glove box, we consider that there is no oxygen, and whatever the oxygen, if it is there also, it has been reacted with the hydrogen and made water. Now, the inoculation or the transfer of the particular anaerobic bacteria to the your nutrient media, and incubation, the particular period where we are making the temperature and pH, maintaining the temperature and pH, and we are keeping the assembly for the certain period of time. All these things will be done into the box and not outside of the box. That's the theme. You need to be very much careful. One more, apart from the box, we are having jar also. That jar is also very, very important, right? The designing, it's not a normal jar that we are generally we use, right? So anaerobic jar, obviously when it will be anaerobic jar, obviously the particular tool, it is having the capability to make the surrounding, make the inside environment free from oxygen. So let us understand how this jar function. Anaerobic jar is a heavy walled jar. Yeah, we can see here, right? The jar wall, it should be heavy walled so that it can protect, right? With a gas tight seal, even gas tight seal also it is there, right? So within which tubes, plates, or other containers to be incubated are placed, along with hydrogen and carbon dioxide generating system. That's what gas pack system it is called. You can see here, hydrogen and carbon dioxide generating system. These bags are not for purposeless here. What these bags are doing, they are generating carbon dioxide and hydrogen to make this area one of the artificial atmosphere accept oxygen, which will be useful for the microorganism, and at the same time they are not going to interfere. After the jar is sealed, here oxygen present in the atmosphere inside the jar, chances are there, right? Because oxygens are everywhere. So during the closing the container or during the transfer of your media inside, chances are there. So even careful also, if it is present in the atmosphere inside jar and dissolve into the culture medium, is gradually used up. How? Through the reaction. With whom? With the hydrogen in the presence of catalysts. That catalysts are initiating that such kinds of reaction inside, and whatever, because hydrogen, it is increasing here, you can see into this slide, and this hydrogen, it will react with the oxygen. That's what we could see in the box also, and it will make the water contained, and it will not, the oxygen will not remain. The air in the jar is replaced with the mixture of hydrogen and the carbon dioxide, thus leading to anoxic condition. That is our intention to for our microorganism. We are thinking for the microorganism that they should not face oxygen, because oxygen are enemy for our microbes which we want to cultivate. So we have to make the environment where incubation it is going on, it should be anoxic condition or free from oxygen condition, right? That is our intention to do so. So how we can conclude after after going through this anaerobic requirement of the particular bacteria, right? Oxygen is very important gas. Yes, it is important gas for us in out atmosphere, right? When we culture the small living organism that is called anaerobic bacteria, which doesn't require oxygen, then the task become complex or challenging. Okay. The sample of collection is also critical, since it should be obtained the place which is free from oxygen. So during the incubation, when we are keeping them for the incubation period, we need to ensure that the oxygen should not reach the area where microbes are growing or they are developing or they are doing all their mitosis, meiosis, replication, and whatever the pattern they adopt for the growth, that if they are doing so, oxygen should not reach that area to disturb their growth, right? So the method and tools, the methods and the tools should be improved to ensure anaerobic cultivations or anaerobic culture of the bacteria, so that we can ensure that there are no oxygen contained which can interfere the growth of anaerobic bacteria, right? So this is the theme.